Had some folks recently that even have been today, struck by lightning out on the beaches, struck today in Chicago. Don't take chances. When you're out there on the beach, you're obviously the tallest thing.
Yeah.
And lightning will attract the tall objects.
So the second you hear that thunder, better yet, keep an eye on the radar once you notice the dark clouds. But yeah, if you're waiting and you hear that thunder, now is the time to move. Severe thunderstorm watch in play across parts of southwest Virginia all the way up into South Jersey, where we've got those active warnings right now.
This goes until 10 o'clock this evening. Take a look at the radar tonight. We'll put it on there and show you what's happening. Storms that we showed you over there through the Northeast, but also storms now in central Virginia.
Yeah, we've got some strong storms rolling through. These are Appomattox and Buckingham counties. This is off to the west, or rather the east of Lynchburg.
Alex.
Oh, you're good. No problem. Shoot, you shouldn't apologize to me. I'm like a student driver on this thing. I'm doing my best. But yeah, this is going to be crossing over 20, heading off to the north of Farmville. Remember that game?
No.
Wasn't there an app game called Farmville?
Yeah. Yep.
Wasn't that the rap show where Eminem got his start?
Maybe.
Never mind.
We've got some serious research to do. Farmville, I don't think you're going to see much of this. I think it's going to drift right off to the north. You notice this is staying south of Charlottesville and 64, but we'll keep a close eye on this. You know, we were talking about the main threats with today's storms. Wind being one of the primary ones across the east. And if you're at home asking why, we've got a guy for that.
That's right. Carl Parker looking at the atmosphere. Carl, give us a little explanation so viewers at home understand why these storms are such prolific wind makers.
Jacksonville, I'm looking at you. Sorry, I know. You're not the only one, though, so you're in it with friends. We'll talk about that in just a moment. But notice New York City, you actually get some relief from the heat, the showers, the storms along that dip in the jet stream. That's going to allow those temperatures, dare I say, to sag below average over the next several days. By next Wednesday and Thursday, we're a bit above average, but not by a lot. Let's talk about today's forecast. And there is that dip in the jet stream. We've seen the showers and the storms from Chicago all the way to the East Coast. That's going to settle in over parts of the Midwest, the Northeast through the weekend. Notice as we get into next week, especially by Tuesday and Wednesday, heat returns to areas like Chicago through the plains. But still across the east, we're staying on the more comfortable side. Notice who's not getting in on this break at all, parts of the Southeast. So heat lingers, and the uncomfortable, the dangerous, the horrid heat lingers. Excessive heat warnings in play for the areas in pink, heat advisories for the areas in red. Tomorrow in Wilmington, it will feel like 106 when you factor in that high of 98 and the dew point of 72. Savannah, how about a 100 degree high, a 69 degree dew point? 106 is your feels like temperature. And into the weekend, that upper level high pressure staying off the coast will keep that humidity in play, will keep those high temperatures. And we could even see some records fall across parts of the southeast. Tomorrow, how about 99 in Charleston? It'll feel like 106, though. 94 in Tallahassee, it'll feel like it's over 100. 102, your feels like temperature in Orlando on Saturday. Jacksonville will feel like 106. And on Sunday, still feeling like 100 in Raleigh. 105 in Charleston by early next week. Charleston, Jacksonville, and Orlando keep heat index values over 100 degrees. So it stays very uncomfortable and dangerously hot, of course, into the early part of next week. Now, I know it's summer and it's supposed to be hot, but for Atlanta, where the average high is 89, you're still staying into the low and mid 90s all the way through early next week. It has been a long stretch for folks in Atlanta, and unfortunately, can't offer up much relief. The best I can do, Mike, is close to average tomorrow.
We'll take average at this point.
Yeah.
Right? Beats what we've
better had. Than the other alternatives.
Okay.
No, that's too slow.
I'm not
those things only go like, I think, 20 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Or 12 miles an hour.
You'd end up getting off of that and running.
Yeah.
There's stuff like hail and lightning and
but from far
stuff.
Away. From really,
although
really
I'm sure
far away.
It's not really storm chasing.
We brought up that Bourbon Street camera. Lowry just went,
Yeah.
No, I was thinking
it was
pretty
cool.
If they had drinks or not had drinks.
Are we going to take it again?
Do they have cup holders, Alex?
I don't know.
Do they have cup holders?
On the Segway.
Oh, no.
Don't Segway and drive?
Technically.
Don't drink and Segway?
Yeah, it's not something we're encouraging,
Mike,
but it's New Orleans.
Don't do that.
It's New Orleans.
Like everything's legal there. It's like Vegas.
I would never do such a thing. I actually didn't. It was like noon. So. It's too early.
How about those storms?
Oh, and they need it. The problem is when you talk about a lot of rain in a short period of time, it can also bring for the threat of flooding. So down through Tennessee, all the way up into Massachusetts, flash flood watches are posted. Into the weekend, there's that dip in the jet stream. We'll watch showers and thunderstorms develop along and south of that. So they got that warm, moist air mass, especially to the south of it. Scattered rain and storms likely. Even tomorrow, though, from New England back into the Ohio Valley, watch for some of that wet weather. Again on Saturday, many of the same locations could see some rain showers, some thunderstorms. And guess what happens on Sunday? More the same. So again, watch for rain and thunderstorms out there. If you get a few rounds of rain, particularly heavy storm bringing a lot of rain, that's when you could see those flash flooding issues. Even into Monday of next week, the wet weather will linger for this part of the country. So that's why we've got the flash flood warnings south of Barbersville.
Check it out. We'll put it on max 40.
So. Yeah, be patient.
Yep.
That's picture.
LOL.
Oh, I was wondering.
ROFLL or... I don't know all the acronyms the kids are saying these days.
Yeah,
you guys
cool.
are all much cooler and younger than I am. So, folks, thank you for your questions this evening. If you have more, use the hashtag WUTV on Twitter.